music venues across the country are hemorrhaging money. Iconic stages are on the brink of closing unless lawmakers in Washington pass a bill bailing out small businesses. Den Bowens visited a legendary promoter to find out what's at stake if theaters shut down for good.
Yeah, there's nothing like being at a show, being at a concert, and the air between the performer and you. You know, it's got magic in it. The pandemic, what we've all been through these last few months, has probably made us realize how much there is magic in the air when you're live and in person and at the concert.
It is Peter Shapiro, legendary promoter and owner of the Capitol Theater in Westchester County.
We spent 2 years renovating the Capitol Theater. It's an amazing, you know, rock palace.
In the 1970s, the Rolling Stones and David Bowie performed here. Janis Joplin famously wrote Mercedes-Benz here just before going on stage. And the Grateful Dead played 18 times in just 1 year.
But then it went away, really, in the 80s.
Shapiro restored it in 2012. Since then, they've hosted more than 800 shows.
Bob Dylan played the opening night in 2012 when we reopened. Having Robert Plant from Led Zeppelin was amazing for us. Neil Young did a few nights just a year or two ago.
The groups for this spring and summer still posted out front, but everything stopped in March, the pandemic pulling the plug, just like it did for live music venues, big and small, across the country.
I think we all missed that so much, and we realized how lucky we were. We're trying to focus on the positive.
Without people to fill the venue, the Capitol Theater wants fans to own a part of the legacy. So they're selling personalized tiles that would be placed outside of the marquee, out front, maybe a tribute to a favorite show or a favorite band. It'll also help keep the venue going.
So right now, we're in the tile business at the Capitol Theater. We used to be in rock and roll, but we're going to do rock and roll into tiles. Back to rock and roll.
In the U.S., it's estimated live music venues have lost $9 billion in revenues. Lawmakers in Washington now debating a possible bailout, the Save Our Stages Act, a bill providing small business loans to stay afloat until people can come back. And at the Cap Theater, hopefully, see their own names under that marquee up front.
When the time is right, people are going to say, I'm going to that show. Concert, Broadway, whatever it is, being with people, humans, that, you know, that may be a while, but when it comes, I think it's going to come back really strong.
Dan Bowers, Fox 5 News.
Yeah, my last concert was Trey at the Capitol Theater this January.
Wow.
I'm going to buy my tiles. All right, Major League Baseball getting tough with its new COVID-19 safety protocols.
New rules, players must...